Now, your exclusive 7 Storm Team forecast.
Hey, welcome back, everybody. Our sleep tight weather view takes us to a live look at the Bayview Bridge. A wonderful afternoon going into a Monday evening here across the tri-states. A little bit of cloud cover and some drizzle here in Quincy earlier. Some heavier storms with some good downpours and a little bit of lightning back out for our western viewers. But it has all since dissipated, and we're left with pretty clear skies and very comfortable temperatures as well. Our high, official high, was 83 degrees here in Quincy. That is 2 degrees below our average. And our low was 1 degree below average at the low of 65 degrees. So, yeah, very comfortable out there. The humidity wasn't too bad. You got out and enjoy it. It was a fabulous day to do so. Mold spore count is still up there, way past the moderate category towards the high category. Weed pollen up there as well. A little bit of grass pollen out there for you allergy sufferers. Take a look at the Macomb Skycam. Gorgeous skies out there, clear skies, sunshine, 81 degrees, dew point 60 degrees, a little bit of humidity, no big deal. North-northwest wind right now at 5 miles per hour. And across the area, yeah, temperatures in the upper 70s to lower 80s, 83 in sunshine, Jacksonville and Pittsfield, upper 70s in Fort Madison, 79. Just a few clouds out in Kirksville at 78 degrees. Now, just at the beginning of the three-hour loop here, you could see the showers that affected just south of Kirksville that moved off to the southeast. Little bit of a boundary right here. I'll zoom out to see really anything else going on. Not much. There is a cold front. Well, the cold front that passed through earlier that gave us the severe storms last night has stalled out. It's what's been causing the storms out to the west here where Kirksville is, and actually causing the same storms out towards Ohio. Now, we, of course, don't have to worry about those storms out to the east, but we will continue to focus on the stalled out cold front, just a stalled boundary now, for possible more shower and thunderstorm development, especially through the night tonight. Decent chance that the storms will fire up overnight into the early morning hours. By the afternoon, I'm hoping that we get a good day across our viewing area. But we could see some more redevelopment of those showers and thunderstorms again by tomorrow afternoon into tomorrow evening. And they're going to be along that boundary. So I think the best chance right now is for our viewers further south and further out to the west. But I think everyone might see an outside chance for a shower or a thunderstorm. By Wednesday, a better chance, I think, for everybody as we look to the southwest. That boundary will actually wash out, but a surface low will begin to move into our area, giving us a more widespread chance for showers and thunderstorms for your Wednesday afternoon. As far as the short-term forecast is concerned, we'll look at tonight into the overnight hours, and the best chance for seeing any of those showers and thunderstorms will be for our southern and western viewers, maybe just an outside chance here through Quincy and back through Hannibal and along I-72 towards, and then back to the west towards Kirksville. As far as those lows tonight go, quite cool, cooler than we've seen recently, low 60s. And here's what I was talking about in the RTs, maybe some upper 50s back towards the Macomb area. And I'm not sure we have seen those upper 50 degree readings in quite a few months now. So maybe just a taste of fall coming up here in early August. Maybe we'll see if they actually drop that low. High temperatures today, called mid-80s, very similar to what we had today. Should be pretty nice in the afternoon before some possible more shower and thunderstorm development tomorrow evening. Again, the best chances will be further south and west. Then everybody, I think, gets in on the action for Wednesday as that surface low approaches. Hopefully we can dry out for our Thursday and our dew days out in Camp Point. Temperatures look quite nice. Hopefully we can dodge the rain. And then look at the temperatures coming into this weekend. Maybe highs only in the upper 70s. Definitely a different kind of weather pattern we're going to be entering, and a bit of a cool down with, again, it looks like maybe a warm-up by next week. But this weekend, yeah, cooler temperatures, maybe taste of fall, maybe.
But you know what? Murphy's Law says it'll get very hot when kids move go back to school.
Is that what's going to happen?
That's what's going to happen.
I believe it.
Well, very good news for football fans.